Hi everyone, it's Mr. Wyman. I'm going to read to you a story called Ellen Ochoa, Astronaut. Now, astronaut is a job, and what is Ellen Ochoa? It's a name of a person, and the type of text that would talk all about a person's life is called what? That's called a biography. And you know what I just did there? I answered the first question that's going to be on your quiz that you're going to have about this story, this text. Here are some other questions that you're going to want to listen for. Why did Ellen Ochoa's mother tell her to reach for the stars? When that line comes up in the text, you're going to want to remember, oh, that's a question that's on the quiz. I should pay extra special attention to this. And you'll have access to this video and the actual text when you take the quiz. So look back for these answers when you come across the questions in the quiz. Why is Ellen Ochoa's flight into space special? Like, what's the big deal? Why did Ellen Ochoa fly on the space shuttle at all? What was the mission of the space shuttle when she flew on it? Why did the author mention Ellen's failure to be accepted into the space program initially? In other words, she didn't get accepted the first time she applied. Why did the author mention that? Why not only talk about her successes? How would you describe Ellen Ochoa's character? What's she like? And in the quiz, it's going to give you, I think, four different character traits. Which one matches up with what you learned about Ellen Ochoa the best? Why was Ellen Ochoa Astronaut written? So listen carefully for the answers to these questions and one more, the written response question. This one I'm going to be looking for you to provide specific details from the text to back up your answer. And here's the question. Ellen Ochoa becoming an astronaut was the result of many things. What happened in Ellen's life that helped her to be the first Hispanic woman in space? Provide specific details from the text. So, she didn't just fall into this job. How did she get to become an astronaut? Did she know someone who was an astronaut? Was she super talented and the program was like, oh, we have to have Ellen Ochoa? Listen to the text, read the text to find the answer to this question. When Ellen was growing up, her mother told her to reach for the stars. That was one of the questions. Ellen had no idea that one day she would explore space. After many years of hard work, she became the first Hispanic woman to travel into space. She is a leader for people of all ages. This is her story. That is a pretty nice introduction to the text, isn't it? Like, tells you exactly what to expect and gives you a little preview, too. Ellen Ochoa was born in Los Angeles, California, on May 10th, 1958. Her mother worked hard to raise Ellen and her sister and brothers. She taught her children how important it was to do well in school. She told them that if they worked hard, they could grow up to be anything they wanted to be. In 1969, when she was just 11 years old, people first landed on the moon. So when Ellen was only a child of 11, she witnessed the first moon landing. That must have been a big deal. It was a very exciting time. Many children wanted to be astronauts when they grew up, too. At that time, there were no women astronauts, so Ellen never dreamed of going into space. In school, Ellen was a top student and did well in all her classes. She loved music and learned to play the flute. Ellen spent hours practicing and became a very talented player. In high school, she played with a band for young people. Here's a caption telling you what this photograph is all about. Ellen would later enjoy music in space too. Like I see a keyboard, and I believe there's an image later on of Ellen actually playing the flute in the space shuttle. Ellen also loved math. Some people told her that girls were not good at math students. She didn't let those people hinder her learning. Ellen always did her best. When she graduated, she had the highest grades in her class. Ellen decided that she wanted to be an engineer. There were people who did not think that a woman could do such a difficult job. Ellen had to study very hard, but she did well. She felt very proud when she graduated and got a job as an engineer. Inventor and musician. That's the heading of this section. As an engineer, Ellen Ochoa made robots that used special tools to see things around them. She and her team found a way for these robots to make computer parts. She wrote and spoke to many people about her invention. And here's another caption. Ellen Ochoa worked as an engineer at the Ames Research Center in California. Music remained an important part of her life. Playing the flute made her feel happy. She played so well that she won an award. Ellen Ochoa enjoyed her job and her music, but she wondered what else she could do. Her friends said she should try to become an astronaut. So in 1985, she decided to apply for a job in the space program. She was disappointed when she was not accepted. Then she remembered what her mother had told her. If she worked hard, she could be anything she wanted to be. This caption says, Ellen Ochoa enjoyed playing the flute, just as this girl does. So do you think that girl is a, do you think this is a picture of Ellen Ochoa? It's not. It's just a picture of a girl playing the flute. Ellen Ochoa waited for another chance to become an astronaut. While she waited, she joined a space research center. There, she helped astronauts learn more about space. She learned to fly a plane and found that she loved to fly. Ellen Ochoa was now a musician, an inventor, and a pilot. She knew how to work on a team. She knew how to keep trying when things were difficult. These sound like pretty important character traits. Ellen Ochoa practiced flying and became a pilot. This must be a picture of her flying a plane. In 1990, Ellen Ochoa's dream came true. She was chosen for the astronaut program. More than 2,000 people had applied to become astronauts, and she was one of just 22 who were chosen. Ellen Ochoa and Eileen Collins posed together on their first day of training at NASA. It's been so exciting for her. Astronaut training is the heading of this section. Ellen Ochoa and her husband moved to Texas so that she could begin her astronaut training. Astronauts must learn to do things differently in space. Ellen Ochoa had to learn to use computers and special tools in space. Working inside a heavy spacesuit is not easy. It takes a lot of practice. Sounds like she would have to have an important character trait to do that. Astronauts wear special suits during much of their training. Ellen Ochoa made a lot of friends in the astronaut program. Ellen Ochoa learned to work with a team of other astronauts to get jobs done. Astronauts become good friends because they spend so much time together. It is important that astronauts exercise to stay in shape. In her training, Ellen Ochoa learned how to use special exercise machines in space. She also had to learn new ways to eat. In space, foods placed on a plate would float away, so astronauts' meals must come in special packages. Astronaut training was hard, but Ellen Ochoa didn't give up. She knew she would have to keep working to be ready to go into space. This whole section seems like it definitely points at a specific character trait. A trip into space. Finally, in April 1993, Ellen Ochoa became the first Hispanic woman to go into space. She flew on the space shuttle Discovery. The Discovery astronauts had a special job to do. Oh, I think that we might learn the answer to one of our questions here. Their job was to learn about the sun. Ellen Ochoa was able to use what she had learned about robots while she was in space. Her job was to control a robot arm on Discovery. She used the arm to catch a satellite that had been studying the sun. The information from the satellite helped the astronauts learn more about the sun's energy. And here is a caption explaining that this is the crew of the space shuttle Discovery. The space shuttle Discovery lifts off from Cape Canaveral in Florida. And here's a picture of Ellen Ochoa playing the flute in space. Ellen Ochoa was amazed at how beautiful Earth looks from space. She also enjoyed floating from place to place inside the shuttle. The astronauts had to strap themselves down to work and exercise. They slept strapped into sleeping bags on the walls. Ellen Ochoa even strapped herself down when she wanted to play her flute. Ellen Ochoa made beautiful music in space. Ellen Ochoa made three more trips into space. On one of those trips, she visited the space station. Her job was to deliver supplies so that other astronauts could live and work there. So the initial travel into space of Ellen Ochoa on the Space Shuttle Discovery was to study the sun and work with a satellite. In one of her trips to space, they delivered supplies to the space station. So her trip to the space station was for that reason. And the caption here says, "Here, Ellen Ochoa delivers supplies to the space station." Ellen Ochoa tells her story to children all over the country. They are very interested in what it is to be like to be an astronaut. The most important thing Ellen Ochoa tells children is what her mother told her. If you work hard, you can make your dreams come true. And here's a photo taken aboard the space shuttle Atlantis in 1994. If you need to, go back, watch this video again, read the text to yourself, see if you can find all the answers to the questions that I read at the beginning of this video. They'll be on your quiz that you're going to take tomorrow. Good luck!